Hello, I'm Helen Ferre. Now that Cuba has officially been removed from the terror watch list, many are eager to visit and explore the island nation. One local Cuban-American attorney has just returned and will join us to share her experience later on. And call me Caitlin, a phrase that has taken over social media the world round. We'll discuss the reaction to Bruce Jenner's transition to Caitlin later on with FIU psychology professor Asia Eaton. But first, last week we spoke to Michael Spring, the director of the Department of Cultural Affairs for Miami-Dade County and senior advisor to Mayor Carlos Gimenez, about the mayor's plan to privatize Vizcaya Museum and Gardens and what this would entail. Two of the mayor's biggest opponents on this issue have been school board member Raquel Regalado, who is running for Miami County Mayor, and Miami-Dade County Commissioner Xavier Suarez, who has yet to confirm whether he will run, wrote an op-ed in the Miami Herald in which they call to the proposal to privatize premature and lay out their plan, which would include encouraging community input. Here to share more on this proposal, we welcome Miami-Dade County Commissioner Xavier Suarez, representing District 7. Good to see you, Commissioner. I don't know, you were former Miami mayor, so it's like mayor, commissioner. Actually, protocol would say mayor. Good to see you, Mayor. How are you?
Good, excellent. And by the way, you thank me for coming to your program. And I want to thank you because every time I come here, besides engaging in an interesting conversation with you, an illuminating conversation, I also get to meet some very interesting people. The two guests that you have today, I mean, amazing folks. And I've exchanged business cards and we're talking psychology and talking about Cuba. And
things, two issues that are right.
Yes.
Of great interest to you. But also you took this issue of Vizcaya. You feel that this is premature. Why?
And by the way, it's not a sort of point counterpoint with Mayor Jimenez. What the mayor wants to do and what Michael Spring has recommended, which is to ultimately have one governing board or trust for both the existing Vizcaya Gardens and Palace, really, the residents of the Deerings, and the other side of the street that used to be connected, which is the current Museum of Science property, which is itself a very important facility, a very important property, and something that can be a magnificent jewel for the county going forward. The idea that ultimately they should be governed by the same trust makes some sense to me, and that's the only thing that I had heard prior to the latest memo from Michael Spring. The problem with the idea as now presented is that it also involves some sort of a silent or hopefully well-discussed proposal as to what to do with the Museum of Science.
And the property, because the Museum of Science is leaving.
I'm sorry, the property where the Museum of Science now is. And for for your viewers, the current Museum of Science, which is right across from Vizcaya on South Miami Avenue, is moving to downtown Miami. And so the structure remains, some of the stables and the homes of the employees, what they call the gardens, I guess.
Which was original.
Well, the village, I'm sorry.
Was original to Vizcaya, the Vizcaya estate.
It's where the employees lived and I guess where they had some of the husbandry, some of the animals. But what we do with that property is very important. It has to be discussed. I mean, all of a sudden there's this notion that we're going to spend $100 million and that some of it's going to come from government, mostly from government.
But government, okay, so let me take the other side.
We don't have $100 million.
No, and I think the idea, if I understand it correctly, is that Vizcaya, as most museums around the country, have financial sustainability issues. So the idea is to do public-private partnerships where you have the government, Miami-Dade County, owns it, but in effect, it's subcontracted out to private sector, and it would be run by private sector fundraising capabilities from a board and so on, correct?
And that might make eminently good sense for the Vizcaya Palace and Gardens.
The Vizcayans, as the organization of volunteers and supporters, seem to be in favor of it.
They want to have more control because they think they can raise more money that way. And they've only, I think last year's entire donations was like $160,000. It's not a big chunk of what it takes to run Vizcaya, which is about $8 million. A lot of it comes from ticket sales, by the way. One of the things that I like to see is make it a little bit more affordable to the public. But
at least for Miami-Dade County residents.
Yes, thank
that would
you
be
for
nice.
Making that distinction.
That would be nice.
Yes.
If Miami-Dade County residents. One of the things that people have commented about Vizcaya is that for county residents who have been so supportive and happily supportive of the institution through taxes, that it's once you visit it, there's no reason to go back a second time. If there's an opportunity to develop something appropriately in conjunction, something like what you get with the Biltmore Estates, as Michael Spring has suggested, I would suggest something more like Williamsburg, where the current museum is.
I like
is,
the Williamsburg analogy.
Where you have that Williamsburg, so you get a sense of what Miami was like when Vizcaya was being developed. That gives people, residents, an opportunity to go back and revisit for different reasons. As it is right now, you go there for photographic options for your quinceanera, if your daughter's having a 15.
$250 for that, typically.
Or something like that. And so
weddings, $23,000.
It's pretty sizable. So what can be done to make it more attractive?
Well, and the question has to, again, be split. I mean, what can we do for Vizcaya itself, the palace and gardens? And let me tell you, I don't want to sound critical of that entity or the people who, the volunteers who participate. I think they've done a good job. $2.5 million a year in public subsidies, approximately $6.5 million that come from either ticket sales or donations. It's not a bad combination for something that we would like to see, you know, continue and
what are the questions you think
none of that solves what needs to be done on the other side of the highway.
Okay, so what needs to be, how much money do you think we're really talking about to solve, your bigger concern really is governance of the property where we have the Museum
the West,
of Science
right.
is, to call that, which would be the Vizcaya Gardens.
The original. Village, I guess, is
the
what
village.
They're calling.
So the governance issue, what about the dollar issue?
Well, that's the other thing. I mean, if you leave it to the bureaucrats to come up with something that makes sense in terms of the market, they'll always do it wrong. when I was elected, I met with Michael and I met with Joel Hoffman, and they told me their idea, which is still the idea that they're pushing forward here, of having a visitor center. Well, that to me sounds like the most absurd idea in the world, that there's not going to be any visitors. That area is right next to that highway where US 1 comes into Brickell, to South Miami, to the entrance to Key Biscayne. It's one of
you
the most.
You have a hospital nearby.
Yes, you have ambulances and rescue vehicles. It's one of the most dangerous intersections in Miami. To expect people to go through that intersection on the way to a visitor center, it doesn't make any sense. Now, if they mean by that like a gift shop that somehow ties into the existing Vizcaya, that should be on the other side of the highway. That should be right next to Vizcaya, not in the property that we're talking about. The property we're talking about has some interesting features. And again, sometimes the bureaucrats.
What should be concerned about? What should in your mind, what is the vision that should be considered for that property?
Well, Raquel Regalado has proposed, among other things, that the governance of it be by the Parks Department, and that as much of it be left open as possible for the summer program that they have there. They have a summer camp that is science-based. Those kids are not going to be able to go to downtown, because nobody's going to be able to go down to downtown for the most part during weekdays, and expecting them to do that doesn't make any sense. The structure includes a gorgeous planetarium. When my kids were growing up, we lived a block away, and it's a privileged location to live. Don't expect other people to do this, but we had a membership for the family, which was like $25. And my kids would go there and get the benefit anytime they wanted. It was available all the time. How to continue some of that in terms of the planetarium itself, the structure, might be useful for some other arts facility. I've already put forth at a Sunshine meeting that we had this week. We've already had success, by the way, because we've already started the consultative process. I also And I was saying about the Sunshine Meeting, I put forth two ideas of two other arts entities that might want to use this facility to the extent that it can be preserved. And that's the other thing we have to do in Miami. We have to figure out how to preserve structures that are...
But preserving structures, but only the ones that are really the most meaningful, perhaps.
The planetarium one is...
And so when you look at this, I don't know that the planetarium is going to be able to compete with what the Frost Museum is doing.
No, I mean just as a structure.
I mean,
for example, it could have a symphony there. One of the ideas that I
proposed. Don't you come back then into the economic issue and sustainability issue?
Yes.
Are we going to continue adding on arts and culture when we have a huge growth in that area and a sustainability issue as well? So if we keep adding on to it, how are we going to continue to finance
that's it? That's precisely the point. We want to put out some kind of an RFA, request for applications, request for interest, an RFI. We have all these initials in government, to see what other arts collections, what other symphonies, what other arts facilities that already exist, collections that already exist, that we don't have to buy, that we don't have to subsidize, can maybe come and use this facility. And with their own donors, their own patrons, creating a trust for something that we don't know what it's going to look like, it's premature.
And just very quickly, what has been the response of Mayor Jimenez's office and Michael Spring over your suggestions?
They said that he acknowledged at the request, by the way, also of Commissioner Sosa and Commissioner Soto and the chairman, they've proposed a workshop for the entire commission. I prefer to have it go to committees. We have committees. We meet every month in committee. I now belong to 8 different committees and boards of the county, and some of them meet twice a month. So I have like 3 every week. And we have the committees already established. People can come, they can speak, they can give us ideas. And also, we have to consult the community. We maybe should have at least 1 town hall meeting at a location, as we were talking about before the program, that people can go to that's not downtown. Maybe, you know, Miami City Hall is one that I always like because the parking is great and you know.
And it's right nearby to the location you're talking
exactly.
about. Commissioner Xavier Suarez, thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you for inviting me.